LoRa modulation is used in many applications like LoRaWAN or Meshtastic. Another application, a LoRa one-to-one link, can be beneficial because it inherits all the good properties like long distance and low power. It is simple, does not need an infrastructure, and can be used bidirectionally. Because I want to build a long-range bidirectional mailbox notifier, I will evaluate a few LoRa boards, connect them to an ESP32 and an ATTINY1614, and finally integrate them via MQTT into Home Assistant. Gritzy YouTubers, here is the guy with the Swiss accent, bringing you a new episode with fresh ideas around sensors and microcontrollers. Remember, if you subscribe, you'll always sit in the front row. To get a mailbox notifier, we have to understand how to build a reliable wireless system, create a high-level block diagram, compare several LoRa boards and decide on the appropriate one. Do the same with microprocessors. Build several devices for a proof of concept. And build a working prototype and do the power measurements. Currently, my mailbox notifier uses LoRaWAN and the Things network. Recently, it has become less reliable than in the past. The reason? Because LoRaWAN uses the ALOA or transmit and forget principle. It works excellently with sensors. If a value does not get through, the following one will. That is not what I want for my mailbox notifier, because it only transmits data if it reaches a new state. Therefore, I always and immediately want to get notified when the mail arrives, even when radio interference blocks a message. To save energy, I only want to transmit when the state of the mailbox changes from empty to full or vice versa, not every few minutes. In technical terms, I want a guaranteed transaction, not just a notification. So I need a back channel to confirm that the message arrived. This could be done with standard LoRaWAN by using downlink messages. But this is cumbersome and slow, and the number of downlink messages is also limited. Would a mesh network like Meshtastic help? Meshtastic offers message acknowledgement, and this could be a good way if you have to bridge a significant distance and therefore need repeaters, or if the notifier is moving. Mine is fixed, and the distance is okay for a single LoRa hop. So I do not need to go the Meshtastic route. I choose a simple automatic repeat request or ARQ system. And our block diagram looks like this. Two switches can wake the battery-powered MPU. Both start the LoRa module, which transfers the appropriate status, empty or full, wirelessly. The receiver or gateway acknowledges the received code by transmitting an acknowledgement code. It also creates an MQTT message with the current mailbox status. The gateway is mains powered and connected to Wi-Fi. The mailbox notifier retransmits its messages until it is confirmed. Because the notifier is battery operated, I will include a timeout to avoid a flat battery in case of problems. That way, I always and immediately get my message if the system is not broken, even if there are interferences on the channel. Next, we have to select a LoRa board. I will not discuss whether to choose 433 or 868 915 MHz boards, because this is a different topic. But we will discuss boards with a built-in MPU and bare chip boards. All boards use old SX127X or newer SX126X LoRa chips. The difference between them is small and unimportant for this project. Just select the appropriate library and wiring. To show you the difference between the two categories, I have these RA02 bare chip boards and this E32 board with an MPU in addition to the LoRa chip. Let's start with the E32 board. eByte manufactures it, and it's part of a bigger family of similar products. You also get 1-watt long-range LoRa boards, for example. All boards are interfaced using a 9600 BPS serial connection. Simple.
They can be used with a terminal program like PuTTY for programming and testing.
However, they only support a dedicated range of commands. For example, you cannot change the spreading factor or other parameters of the chip. Later, we will have a closer look at its usage. The RA02 contains just a LoRa chip and has to be interfaced using SPI plus 2 more pins. It is similar to the well-known RFM69W module. So you need an additional MPU to use this module. However, it is very flexible because your program can influence all parameters of the chip. You can even use it for non-LoRa communication like weather balloon hunting. Also here, you get several versions. Unfortunately, the numbering is not very transparent and you must pay attention to which chip they use for which module. The RA02 is only available in a 433 MHz version, by the way. Because most of us use bare chips for a long time, I focus on the E32. It offers 4 modes. 2 of them are essential for our project. In mode 3, the module sleeps and can be programmed. In mode 0, it transparently transfers all serial data to a receiving module. Like that, it is very convenient to replace a serial cable with a wireless link. The 2 other modes are used to sleep the receiver.
But because the receiver in our setup is mains powered, I do not need it.
You will find more information in the datasheet.
Programming is quite easy.
You can download a Windows program and connect it via USB to serial adapter to an E32 module. Then you can read and write all 5 module registers. You should get a transparent serial connection if you store the same values in both modules, at least if you disable the fixed mode. In fixed mode, you can build a network of such modules. Another important field is I/O mode, where I select push-pull to avoid pull-up resistors. The air rate can be adjusted to your needs. Keep in mind, the higher this rate, the lower the range of the modules. For continuous transmission, I would set the air rate higher than the UART rate. For my project, it does not matter because the chip has buffers, and I only want to transfer 1 byte at a time. FEC, or Forward Error Correction, duplicates the content of a message in an intelligent way. Like that, a slightly disturbed message can still be decoded. It is often used when no backchannel exists. We do not need this feature because we have a backchannel and use ARQ. A disturbed message will be automatically retransmitted. The channel determines the frequency. Unfortunately, the channel spacing is 1 MHz. Here is the formula. So you have to pay attention to which one you use. Channels 23 and 24 are in the European 433 MHz ISM band.
And channels 5 and 6 are in the 868 MHz band,
if you use UHF modules. Remember, also here you must not transmit more than 1% of the time. The datasheet shows a summary of all registers, but fortunately you do not need it. You just select the appropriate parameters and save them to the module. From now on, it does not require any programming. If you want to do the same with a microcontroller, copy these register values into an array, add C0 hex, switch the module to mode 3 and write them via serial. Simple. But how do you switch the modes of the module? With these 2 lines, M0 and M1. A typical sketch looks like this. In setup, start serial with the correct UART speed, select mode 3, and write these 6 bytes. You even could omit this step if you pre-program your module. In loop, you read or write the values with serial commands. Within ESP32, I connected the E32 module to serial 2 and could still debug the program with standard serial. Very comfortable. These modules also work with very limited MCUs like an ATTINY, as we will later see. The interface needs at least 3 pins. If you want to program it with your MCU, you need 5. A library exists for the E32. However, it is pretty complex and unnecessary if you only want to transfer a few bytes. Because the RAO2 has to be programmed on the chip level, I strongly suggest using Sandeep Mistry's LoRa library. It is simple to use and works on several MCUs. Here, the interface needs 6 pins. So let's connect both modules to an ATTINY1614 with 14 pins, because we need 5 or 6 pins to interface the LoRa modules, plus 2 for the switches, and maybe 1 to switch the LoRa module completely off using a MOSFET. As shown in video number 477, programming these newer ATTINYs is straightforward. I built a simple UDP programmer with an USB to serial module and a 4.7 kilo-ohm resistor. You only need 1 pin for programming, and the MegaTiny core does all the heavy lifting. The LoRa library works fine, and the interface pins for both modules are shown here. So let's have a short look at the notifier sketch. As usual, I wrote it as a state machine with 7 states. Some states execute commands and others only wait till one of the exit conditions is met. Then the program moves to the next state. After setup, it starts in the init state. If mail is inserted and the switch at the opening is closed, it advances to the mailbox is filling state and, after transmitting the new state via LoRa, it proceeds to waiting for acknowledgement filled. This is necessary because the wireless transfer forth and back takes some time. If problems occur, it can take even longer because the needed repetitions. As soon as the acknowledgement message arrives, the sketch moves to mailbox filled. Thus, I do not get more than 1 message if the mailman delivers several letters. When I open the door, the process moves to mailbox is emptied, and the whole thing repeats. I use a switch case statement to build the state machine and an enum to get a readable code. Maybe you can comment on whether you also use this method or if you have a better one. Instead of the ATTINY, we also could use any 3.3 volt Arduino or STM32 processor. I propose an ATTINY because it is small, cheap, and has low power consumption. We now have many possibilities and have to decide which one fits best. Let's start with the easy one, the gateway. Because it is mains powered and needs Wi-Fi, the choice is clear. For prototyping, I use my favorite board. For the final setup, I plan to use my other favorite, this Wemos mini board. And because I will use an E32 module for the notifier, I have to use the same for the gateway. It would be too hard to reverse engineer the protocol used by the E32 and implement it with an RAO2. For the mailbox notifier, I use the ATTINY1614 and an E32 module.
Both should have a sleep current of only a few microamperes at 3 volts.
To get such a value with an RAO2, I would need to switch it on and off using a MOSFET. During one transmission of 0.4 seconds, it consumes 41 milliampere on average. Assuming 2 mail deliveries or 4 messages daily, the battery life calculator says that 2 AA cells with a typical capacity of 2500 milliampere hours will last 3047 days or 8 years. That is why I use primary and not lithium batteries for my low power projects. So we have a working prototype. Now I have to add deep sleep to the notifier and two 3D printed cases. I might also create a small PCB for the notifier. What did we learn today? LoRaWAN is perfect for sensors where we can live with some lost values. If we want a transaction-proof system, we have to add a backchannel. Using a one-to-one connection and automatic repeat request creates such a system. Using LoRa modules still is a perfect thing for long distances or, as in the case of my metallic mailbox, the transmitter is residing in a Faraday cage. We get modules with only a LoRa chip or with a LoRa chip and an MCU. Modules with just a LoRa chip interface with SPI and need a library for programming. Modules with an additional MCU can be connected via serial and programmed using a simple terminal. They are easy to handle because they also offer deep sleep out of the box. Because you can program all parameters offline, such modules are perfect for replacing a serial cable with a wireless link. The combination of an ATTINY1614 and an E32 module is a good fit for my mailbox notifier. It should run for about 8 years on one set of AA batteries. An E32 LoRa board connected to a small ESP32 board is a good combination for the gateway because it can produce MQTT messages that can easily be integrated into Home Assistant. That was all for today. As always, you find all the relevant links in the description. If you found this video useful or interesting, please support the channel. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video. Bye!